In this screencast, I'm going to describe the steps used to obtain the work from a steam turbine and what the outlet conditions would be. This is for an irreversible turbine. So what I've drawn here is on a temperature entropy diagram, the phase envelope separating two-phase region, liquid and vapor, from pure liquid or pure vapor. And so our starting condition is right here. This is the inlet condition to the turbine. It's in the superheated region. So I've drawn a constant pressure line for the inlet conditions, and I've drawn a constant pressure line for the outlet conditions. As we move through the turbine, the temperature decreases because we're removing energy in the form of work from the steam, and the entropy increases. This is an irreversible process. So this is the outlet condition, this point here. So in order to calculate the work, what we're going to first do is do the calculation for a reversible process. The first step in order to do that is to determine the inlet condition. So we need the inlet enthalpy and the inlet entropy. And we're going to get those from the steam tables. And we get those because we know the pressure and the temperature of the starting system. And then, as I mentioned, the steam tables would be for the superheated steam tables for our initial condition. So our second step is to do the calculation for the reversible. And so what we want to calculate is the outlet condition. I'm going to call this point outlet prime. This is a reversible case. This dashed line is the irreversible. And remember, the irreversible corresponds to the actual process that we're interested in. What I want to calculate is the outlet, so let's call that S prime at the outlet, and that's going to be the same as Sn because it's reversible and it's adiabatic. And so our next step then, since we know the outlet pressure that would be given in our problem statement, we now know the outlet entropy. We have two properties of steam or water. Any two properties then uniquely determine all the other properties. And so we can determine, again from the steam tables, H prime out, the enthalpy out if we ran the reversible process. So we get that from the steam tables. And we're able to get that because you know the pressure leaving. And we know S prime out. Our next step is to calculate the work for the reversible process. So the reversible work is going to be enthalpy out prime, because of the reversible, minus enthalpy in. And this number is going to be less than zero because we're getting work out of the system, so the work is going to be negative for this system. So now we have the reversible work. We need to determine the work for the actual system, the irreversible process. So the work for the actual system, let's call it irreversible, is going to be some efficiency times the reversible work. And this needs to be given. This is a property of the system. It's some value less than one because it's irreversible. So once we're given that, we can calculate the irreversible work. One of our objectives is to calculate the irreversible work for this process. Now we can calculate the outlet condition. And we do that from the first law, because the irreversible work is going to be H out minus H in. So this H out, of course, corresponds to this point here. We know the irreversible work, we know H in, so we can calculate H out just from this first law. And so now we have H out and pressure out, which means we can go to the steam tables. Again, we have two properties. They uniquely determine the system properties. So we now can determine other properties of the system, entropy out, temperature out, etc. So that basically completes the procedure. The idea is we first do the calculation for a reversible process. Then we take advantage of information about how irreversible by knowing what the efficiency is to calculate the conditions for the irreversible process.